My wonderful parents and students at home.
Hope
you're enjoying yourself. And hope you're keeping safe. I still remain your free teacher, the person you know from Benin Penel, Mr. Odupe Olayinka. So I want to continue from where we stopped in the last class. You know, in the last class, we discussed about fishery. We talked about fishing. And also, aside from that, we look at the definition of fishery. I told you that fishery involves the activities. It involves the activities of production and management of what? Aquatic fish. And I told you that we have a lot of what? Examples of fish. Like, I know you want to tell me, just like we discussed in the last class. Gave a lot of examples of what? Example of fish. And I told you that fish can be classified into two. Which are what? Those ones that are classified according to their habitats, and the ones that are classified according to their structures. Then we look at the ones that are classified according to their habitats. Then other the ones that are classified according to their habitats. I said we have fresh water habitats, and also we have marine water habitats. I said freshwater habitats and marine water habitats. So also, I mentioned examples of freshwater habitats. I told you I went to talk of freshwater. We are talking about a of what? Of a water that has what? That have zero salt content. And I mentioned example. We have example like the stream, the river, the lake, the port. They are examples of freshwater habitats. Then also we look at some of the examples of fishes that are present in freshwater habitats. I mentioned some of the fishes like catfish, like tilapia, and also carp. I know you want to mention others for me. Then also we look at those ones that are found in marine water habitats. I told you that when we talk of marine water habitats, which is also known as saltwater habitats, that is, it has low, it has 1% of salt, so it's salty. That's why it is called saltwater habitats. And I told you that we have example like the sea, we have the lagoons, and also we have the ocean. Then we look at some of the examples of marine habitats. We have example like we have mackerel, we have salt, we have croaker, and so on and so forth. I know you want to mention others for me. Then also, I told you that we have those that are classified according to their structure. According to their structure, which is also called according to their morphology. That is, according to their body structure. And I told you we have those ones that are what? That are bony fish, and those ones that are cartilaginous fish. That is, those ones that has bone, and those ones that have cartilage. And also we gave examples under those ones too. And when you look at examples of those ones that are made up of cartilage, I said we have dogfish and ray fish. Then those ones that are classified under bony fish, we have what? We have mackerel, we have catfish, we have croaker, and so on and so forth. I know you want me or the other, we are beating all these fishes. There are those things we can what? We can see them around us. Some of us, either you helped it last night, or you what? You are meeting it. You are about to take it this morning. So it's not something that is what? That is new to us. It's something that we have seen very well. Had it been we are in normal classes is holding, we can definitely do some experiments, you know, come with a live fish and also some experiments on it. Maybe when we see, we are going to do that. Then aside from that, I told you that it's not only fishes that are present in the world, in the aquatic habitats, that we have other what? Other animals that are present in the, that are called aquatic animals. For instance, we have, I believe you can vividly remember some of these invertebrate animals, like we have the arthropods. Examples of arthropods, they are the insectals. The insectals, examples, we have crabs, we have lobsters, we have periwinkles and so on. Aside from that, you also, I know you want to tell me some of the vertebrates. Examples of vertebrates, you want to tell me that we have the amphibians. Examples of amphibians, we have the toad and the frogs. Also, aside from that, we have the mammals, like whales, like dolphin, and so on. Aside from that, we have the, we also have some of these invertebrates too, like we have I've mentioned arthropods and also I've mentioned mammals. The other one that we have, the reptiles. The reptiles examples are the crocodile and alligators and others. So those ones are other aquatic animals that we can what? We can also find in the what? In the water. Then aside from that, we also discussed some of the importance of fishes. And I told you in the last class that one of the importance of fish is that it serves as a source of protein. It serves as a source of protein to man and also livestock. Like bony fish, we can give it to some of our poultry to what? To feed on. Aside from that, I said it provides employment. And I know you want to mention some other examples, or you want to mention some of the importance of fishes for me. So, we want to continue on our topic, still under fishery. So, what we want to look at this morning is fishing equipment. What did I say? Fishing equipment. So, we want to discuss on some of the equipment that are used for these fishing. So we have fishing equipment, we have various methods that is used for catching fish in our country. So we are just going to discuss few of them. So when we look at fishing equipment, what are fishing equipment? These are equipment that are designed for injuring big fish in water. So let me write it on the board. Fishing equipment. I said fishing equipment. Fishing equipment are the tools or equipment used for injuring big fishes in the water. So fishing equipment are the tools or equipment used for injuring big fishes in the water. Then we have examples of this. We have examples of this fishing equipment. So they are just divided into three. So this, like I said earlier, I said they can be divided into three. Namely, number one, we have the woody equipment. coding equipment, I said it can be divided into three. Namely, number one, we have the wooden equipment. Now, when you look at this wooden equipment is very common because we use it to what? To injure these fishes. We make sure that those fishes did not what? They did not escape. So I will just mention some of these, the example of fishing equipment. Examples are spells. We have spells, we have knife. Now, when you look at this equipment, they are used by an expert for fishermen. So the fishermen, they are the ones that use it. If you don't know how to what, if you don't know how to use some of this equipment, you cannot use it. So we have wooden equipment. Examples of wooden equipment are spell. You just throw it. We have knife. Aside from knives, we have arrows. These are the examples of wooden equipment on the board. This is the spell. You can see the head, how it looks like. We call it the proa. This is the handle. It's the handle that you will hold the handle and what? And you throw it. You would have target where those fishes are. So once you just throw it at them, immediately it will just cut the fish or catch the fish. Then we have the arrow. It's also an example of wooden equipment. Then the next one we have is fishing net. Fishing net. When you look at this fishing net also is common. Fishing net also is common. You will see that most of these when you go to your village, or most of these people, our mothers in the village, that's what they use. So when you look at it, we have fishing nets. And when you look at the fishing nets, we have it on the board there. Example is gill net, e.g. We have the gill net. You will see that it's made up of what? It's made up of a cotton or a nylon, which is thrown into the water to catch the fishes, to catch the fish. So the edge of the net, they are lined with what? With stones. They are lined with stone. These ones are the heavy, they are the stones. You can see that's why it's written heavy stones. Every stone there, that's the stones. So you will see that it is lined with heavy stone or lead, which enable it to sink to the bottom of the water. Then a typical example is gill net. Though we have other ones too, which is cast nets, and also and so on and so forth. I know you want to mention others for me. So we have example which is gill net and cast net. Then lastly we have the fish traps. The fish trap. So we have the fish trap. Example of fish trap is the hook. So example of the fish trap, we have the hook and the fence, etc. I know you want to mention others for me. So we have the fish traps. And when you look at the fish trap, they are also used for catching fish. And under it, we have the hooks and the what? And the fence. And I know you want to mention other example for me. Then aside from that, mind you, we also use what? Example of fish trap, we also have poison baits. We also have poison baits. And when you look at this poison bait, is what? This one also is common. It's common, it's in form of food. So as the fish feed on what? On the food, they will die and they will start floating on the water. So it's a typical example. So I would like to stop here. I would like to stop here and give you assignments. So you forward this assignment to our platform. You make sure you attempt it and forward it to our platform. So let's go through all this and also read up. Also, we can give more example on that. So you have to apply different equipment. Apply different equipment for catching fish. And also, I want you to mention this method of preserving fish. So my dear students at home, apply for different equipment for catching fish, and also you have to mention this method of preserving fish. So let's do this and forward it to our platform. So I remain your agri teacher, Mrs. Olayinka Ogudipe. Make sure you keep safe. Thank you.